And now, juniors. Eight best of them. Waiting for their first flyoff start. There are some good pilots in here, together with some very experienced helpers. So who knows, maybe one of them can surprise us with the full time as well. All high, all to the south again, except one. I don't believe he turned off his motor intentionally. That must have been some kind of mistake or technical issue. Where are the rest? Pretty high, pretty far. One of them waited. Delayed his start. But now all are in this part of the sky. Another one delayed his start. And he is going straight up into the wind. Obviously because the situation here on this side is getting problematic. They are losing their height fast. There's only one that's very far away. That has still a very good height. The others, much closer, are more or less returning to land. Okay. So now it's between, oh, the last one here. It's now between the guy up there in the sky with no reference whatsoever. Let me see if I can even find him. He's there. And on the other side of the valley. The other guy also coming back. This is one of the German guys, I believe. Okay. So now I don't see the other plane at all. Aha, there it is. He was late by a few minutes, I believe. Let's see if he can now make these minutes by the choice of his late start. He's not trying to ride a wave off that tree or maybe off the camp. Trying to gain some time there. So far he is good. He's now 3 minutes more in the air than the last guy who landed. And I think this is more than his original delay on the start. Now, just if he can nail the landing, that's the best score for him. And I believe this is Alen Tutsman from the Croatian team, helped by no other than Arjan Huceljuk, one of the best pilots currently. Let's see what Alen and Arjan will do now. Again, they're waiting. It's now 30 seconds past. I guess they're just observing. Okay, now the Germans have started. One more, and they're still waiting. One minute has passed. Two more planes in the air. Now I see four planes to the south, one to the north, two to the north. 1 minute and a half, and they're still waiting. No, no. Looks like they need to reset the logger. So this wasn't planned. Later they start. And they go straight up. And as high as possible, I would say that it's way over 200 meters. That's now very far away, but to the side. They didn't get far downwind. They're just sticking to the side, which I guess is much easier to return if needed. There's no really strong gust of wind, at least where I'm standing. There are already planes on the ground. And where the others are, I can't see. In the meantime, Alen lost some height. Even the tree doesn't work. Looks like this time that won't be any good. So that was just over 5 minutes of flying. Let me try to find the other pilots. So there are two more on the north side. Very far away. There's one and the other is slightly more downwind. No, they're now getting closer. There they are. So looks like Alen wasn't far enough out from the camp. Or maybe these two guys were much higher from the start, I didn't see. They're also now losing height rapidly. And the others are already getting ready to land. From the German pilot. if any of these two guys started from beginning of working time, they are now making a huge difference in scores. But I'm not sure, and I won't be sure until I check the results. Very nice. Looks like the French team is jumping. Okay, now let's see the results. And then two more flights tomorrow morning, both for juniors and seniors. Hopefully in much more thermal soaring conditions. We are now looking at third round of junior flyoffs. I checked the results from yesterday. Alen Tutsman managed to retain the lead despite his second flight not being the best. Obviously he made enough difference in his first flight. So he now started at a safe height, not risking anything. But if I look around, the rest of the juniors are not that much lower. So I guess he will make a full flight, full time. And the next interesting is this guy here. He's flying solo on the south part of the valley, while the rest are flocking together over the camp, as we've seen in the previous flight, for example. So this whole field is also a pasture, and there's a herd of cows being moved by shepherds every day across it, which means there's like a cloud of flies. And right now they're just killing me. I would need an assistant to keep the flies off me. So looks like middle of the field and south field are holding well. It's good air there. But surprisingly on the north side over the camp, guys have issues. Two already lost height. One will even land outside if he doesn't come back soon. That's unexpected. The other one is here, it's one of the German planes, I believe. So not good for Team Germany. So right now it looks like Croatia is aiming for both junior and senior victory, and I wish them luck. Will that guy manage to climb out? He certainly looks like he's in good air. Very nice. Very nice. So now even Alen Tutsman, with guidance by Arjan Huceljuk, joined this thermal at the top. Now there are 6 planes in here. Just don't crash, guys. Good job. One more flight like this, and he gets the victory. Fourth and last flight for juniors. Looks like they're all collecting again over the camp. Someone is trying much lower than before. They're working pretty hard. It looks like the air just doesn't want to unstick over there. They're just keeping their height, but not really climbing much. At least the one at the bottom really has problems now. Looks like he's now also gaining slowly. The rest of them are much higher by now. So I only see 7 planes in this part of the sky. I don't know where the 8th one is. But anyway, looks like they will all make it now till the end. I'll just move to get the landings. About 1 minute to land.
30 seconds. Someone decided to land early. Now let's wait for the results.